Time and for your trust. I'm Gordon Boyd.
I'm Natasha Williams. First at 6, has Sterlington grown so fast that it can't keep track of its money? Yesterday we told you about an audit that found the town could be more than $100,000 short.
NBC 10's Randall Newsom's been digging into the fine print and talking to Sterlington's interim mayor about what led to this and what's next. Randall.
Gordon, Natasha, the town could be facing a big deficit, but the question on everyone's minds, what caused it, and where does the town's leadership go from here? I sat down with interim mayor Kerry Ely as he continues to search for those answers. The town of Sterlington is trying to fight their way out of some financial trouble, but interim mayor Kerry Ely doesn't want people to hit the panic button just yet.
Do I see the town going bankrupt? No. No doubt we need to tighten our belt. We need to be diligent in watching our expenses.
Unhealthy tone at the top. Overall lack of communication between officials, departments, employees, and contractors. Just a couple things found in last year's audit that have raised concerns here at Town Hall. The audit highlighted several things, some not as specific.
The report's, for the most part, vague.
Others suggest problems that point back to the leadership in place at the time, before Ely took on his role as the interim.
That's really a question that I guess Mayor Breland will have to answer.
An ongoing legal battle with Greater Ouachita Water Company hasn't helped.
Unfortunately, the water suit at this point has not turned out as we would desire.
Now they focus on moving forward.
We look forward to seeing what the legislative auditor has to say. We will take their findings. We will make the corrections that we need to make. And we want to make sure we do things right.
While they wait for the results from the state's investigation.
I'm going to do all I can between now and January 1st to get the town pointed in the right direction.
They control what they can control.
But we're working on some things to get our financial house in order. We're in the process of creating a financial oversight committee.
Ready to face whatever this investigation will uncover.
Now, we spoke with the legislator's office. They say it's early in the investigation, but once it's complete, we'll know the kind of damage that's been done and what can be done to fix it. Live in the studio, Randall Newsom, NBC 10, your local news leader.